I know you all liked my punching dummy project that I did a few months ago. In that video, I made a sensor that helped the fighter train to do the maximum amount of brain damage with each strike. If you missed that video, I link to it below. Today, I'm working with another dummy. So let me explain what I plan to do with it. Because of how I look, some of you have asked if I get bothered just going out or walking around Shenzhen. And the answer is very rarely. Shenzhen is a modern and extremely safe city. And as you've probably seen on the news, we have cameras everywhere. Still, it's smart to plan for the worst. But we also have to plan realistically. Unfortunately, a lot of the advice and training given to women for self-defense is wildly unrealistic. Ramsey Dewey has a great series of videos on just how bad a lot of that advice is. That link is also below. Part of it is decades of myths about what work in real fights despite very little hard data to back these theories up. Part is simply unrealistic expectations. The people giving the advice have usually never fought off someone double their weight and three times their strength. So they mean well, but don't really have a grasp of the basic physics problems someone like me has to deal with. Dudes are much bigger, much stronger, and usually have more experience from being in more physical confrontations. If you think you're just going to kick some guy in the balls, remember they have a lot more experience protecting them than most of us have kicking them. Even with years of training, a 50th percentile woman prevailing over a 50th percentile man in an all-out fight is very unlikely. Yes, we all have stories about some amazing martial arts practitioners, but there's anecdotes and there's real life. If you are a large, strong woman who is well-trained facing a smaller, untrained man, you might stand a chance. But that's not a common scenario. And at 45 kilos, I'm not a large woman. Fortunately, dudes are actually not my primary threat model. When I go out, I usually have one or more male friends who keep an eye out for me. I have housemates, IP cameras, and a silent alarm system if any visitor to my studio makes trouble. With dudes, my job is maintain good situational awareness, control the distance, and stop time until one of my henchmen can get there and throw him in the moat with the alligators. The only time I'm alone with someone out of easy reach of help is when I'm with a girl in my room, and unfortunately, I do like the bad girls and have brought home girls I didn't know all that well more than once. So far, I haven't had any trouble, but it does happen. Domestic violence isn't just something men do to women. Women can do it to other women also. And of course, some women do it to men and men do it to men, which is all just as bad and should all be taken seriously. But for me, I got worried about crazy girls more than anything. So while I'm not going to live in fear or go train martial arts in the mountains for years, it doesn't hurt to have a plan. But also, not does not make sense to invest an unreasonable amount of time. So realistically, my threat model is another woman, no more than 15 kilograms larger than me, and probably stronger and more athletic. I often date in Thailand and many tomboys practice Muay Thai, so trying to poke eyes or throw an elbow and knees is a terrible idea. They've been practicing head movement and some even fighting professionally since they were little kids. They're going to be far better at it. A challenge, but not as difficult as my trying to deal with a full-grown guy. To do this, I've got just one technique. Like Bruce Lee said, I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times. My kick is what judo calls senkaku jumi, what other martial arts call the triangle choke. I have this dummy I can practice with, and sometimes I practice with friends, but I just practice dead choke and free setups. I'm not very interested in sports and don't want to spend too much time on this. I've got too many projects to do. I just don't want to be completely helpless if I get in a bad situation alone in a room with a date or her jealous girlfriend. And like punching bags, grappling dummies are actually terrible training tools. The weight is too dead. It just lies there and it makes all your movements awkward as you drag all that weight around. So I prefer to practice with my friends when I can. Still, this dummy is what I've got right now, so bear with me. The guard position lets me use both my legs to control my opponent, keep my distance, keep them at a distance. I use my hands to keep her head twisted to the side at an angle so she can't get much power or try and bite me. To be honest, if I think help is about to come through the door and I feel like I have good control, I'm just going to relax, control my breathing, and hang out here. Let her burn some energy until she's someone else's problem. No reason to risk losing a safe position trying to sweep or submit. Good game theory means not losing is more important than winning. I'm fine here, but if she's hurting me or help is not coming, I wait until she makes a mistake and one arm is in. Since the dummy can do that, I have to force the arm in and then apply the triangle choke while keeping my face from being hit or scratched and my long hair from being grabbed. What I'm doing here is dumping with one leg and curling with the other. Well, I'm trying to. I'm probably doing it wrong, but you can feel it's very efficient. I've learned it from video series from Ryan Hall, link in the description. Ground fighting is still not common in Asia, and very few women will know how to posture up, pass my guards, or defend a triangle. So I don't need to be all that good at it. And even if I fail, it's a fairly safe position. Also, since they are within 15 kilograms or so and not super strong, there is no risk of me getting picked up and slammed, which is why I would not try this with a full gong guy. Of course, as you can see, my technique is still really bad. You know me, I love to do videos I'm not even remotely qualified to do. It's fun to try new things. You get to have a good laugh, and I think sometimes they give people who are actually qualified interesting ideas. I try to get help with my choke and it's set up from knowledgeable people when I can, but I want a way to make sure I'm doing it right when I'm on my own, that the pressure is on the neck and that there's enough of it to choke a person, because if your body mechanics are off, the choke just doesn't work. The dummy is not great for setups or dynamic movement, but for static positions, I think maybe it can be helpful. So let me show you what I came up with. The thing about a choke is you are pinching off a tube, the arteries. You don't want uniform pressure on the neck. This kitchen scale has a strain gauge. It just shows force, but that means it shows this and this as the same thing. But they aren't. One of those is a good choke and one of those isn't. So I didn't use a strain gauge or any kind of pressure sensor for this, even though it would be easier and cheaper. What I want to measure is deflection, how the neck is compressed at one point. So working with my friends at JLC PCB, I developed this. It uses flex sensors. The total amount they are bent is shown on this display. It's an arbitrary number, but it does correspond to that tube being pinch off, which is what we want. I have this thick yoga mat that approximates the density of a neck. I'm going to mount the sensors in there and get some feedback on choking this dummy.
I'm just going to take a quick minute to discuss this little sensor here. A few years ago, if you wanted something like this, you don't need to be an electrical engineer or hire one to build you a prototype, which would cost thousands of dollars. These days, if you want something like this, or want to modify this one from the open source files I have posted in the description box, it's easy. You want flex sensors in a leg to practice leg locks? No problem. You can have companies like JLC PCB make loads of this for only a few dollars. They can assemble most of it as well with their PCB services. And contract engineering for your own ideas is cheap also on sites like Fiverr or my friends here in Shenzhen. Remember how you wish you had bought Bitcoin when it was dirt cheap? We are kind of there now with hardware development in Shenzhen. In a few years, a lot of people will be wishing they got their idea built in Shenzhen when it was still cheap, because it's starting to get more expensive fast. If you have an idea, get some PCBs made with JLC. It's a fast, easy way to launch a simple Kickstarter project and get into manufacturing. Now, let me get these sensors into my dummy and see if this idea is any good. Okay, well, first off, if I was ever going to take this further, it would need to be wireless. I didn't do it for the prototype because wireless, we have tripled the cost and I didn't know if the idea was any good or not. But if I made another, I'd have made wireless for sure. I think the biggest problem with this build is what I was started with, grappling dummies like this just aren't very useful in the first place, and adding electronics doesn't really help that much. Once I'm in position with the triangle locked in, sure, it worked great, and I really felt how to get the most force, but it's just for practicing that static squeeze. The dummy is so dead, I can't even get into that position in a realistic way. Over time, it would probably even make my technique worse. I think something like molded polyurethane foam over a steel spring skeleton
bolted to the floor or a wall might work better. I have to think about it. Again, nothing will ever be as good as another person. But the purpose of a dummy is to help you build muscle memory through practicing simple techniques far more times and much harder in a single section than a human partner could comfortably sustain. This setup doesn't really let me do that. It just teaches me to squeeze correctly once I get the triangle locked in, which is nice, but pretty limited considering the size and complexity of all this. What do you think? Do you like when I do this sort of video? I'm not a martial artist, so I know I'm wildly unqualified, but I think they'll be fun. What would you do differently? How do you think it can be improved? Let me know in the comments. If you'd like to build your own, I'll link to the source files for the board in the description box. Until next time, remember, if I can do it, anyone can do it.